皆さんにこんにちは。プティと申しますが、フランスに住んでいますね。フランスの南にニースという町ですね。コートダジュール。よく知っていますかもしれないですね。日本にも。ここには4時ですから、少し難しいではないけど、少し早いですね。私が今、イネリアという研究所に勤めています。イネリアという研究所、国立研究所ですね、フランスに一番大きなコンピューターサイエンスの研究所だと思います。今日はいろいろな場所に分散していますね、フランスに。全部で2500人だと思いますね、研究者ですね。私の専門はコンピューター言語ですね。言語です。エコの場合には言語と音楽、発表は英語でしたいと思いますけれども、初めに少し日本語話しますけど、初めに小さなビデオを準備しました。プロジェクトを紹介しているためにこのビデオで始める、予定です。その後、スライドでプロジェクトについて説明をしようと思いますね。そう、初めに小さなビデオ、スクリーン大丈夫だと思いますね。チェックしてみます。エクランパッタジェ、OK。
OK、OK、セイ、OK。
OK、OK、OK。
ジェネレーティブミュージック。つまりアルゴリズムを使って制作されたり、アルゴリズムに助けられたりする音楽には長い歴史があります。最も古い手法の一つは、おそらく18世紀の音楽的なサイコロゲームであろう。今日では文法的な表現、確率的なアルゴリズムの使用、ニューラルネットワーク、ルールベースのシステム、制約プログラミングなど、さまざまな技術や方法論が用いられています。私たちはある意味で音楽的なサイコロゲームに似た複雑な音楽的要素と確率的な現象を組み合わせた新しい手法に興味を持っていますが、その力は同期的なリアクティブプログラミングを使用することにあります。まずコードネームをスキニとするシステムの基本原則から説明します。スキーにはギリシャ語でシーンを意味します。第一の原理はパターンと呼ばれる基本的な音楽要素です。ビットウィグスタジオやエイブルトンライブのようなデジタルオーディオワークステーションの世界では、パターンはクリップと呼ばれています。この2つの用語は実質的に同等ですが、クリップというとループを思い浮かべることが多いのですが、ループ再生を前提としない音楽要素である私たちのパターンの場合はそうではありません。私たちのシステムはパターンの配列によって音楽を生成します。これらのパターンはランダムな現象に反応するシナリオに沿ってセットで構成されています。第二の原則はシナリオです。パターンやランダム性に関する限り、スキーには音楽的なサイコロゲームや組み合わせ生成音楽に非常に近いものがあります。その独創性はランダム性を超えて、作曲家がランダムな出来事に従うかどうかの音楽の振る舞いを記述するシナリオを定義できることです。これらのイベントは時間に関連するもの、特定のパターンやパターンの組み合わせがランダムに発生するもの、さらにはビデオゲームや各種センサーから発生するものなど、システムの外部にあるイベントも含まれます。シナリオの原理に関連する大きな困難は、それを表現し実装するための明確で効率的な方法を見つけることです。パターンの原理やパターンのランダムな活性化に関する私たちの実験では、デジタルオーディオワークステーションや一般的なプログラミング技術によって提案された通常の方法は比較的初歩的であるか、または実装が非常に複雑であることが分かりました。やや複雑なシナリオを作るためには、コンピュータサイエンスでよく知られているオートマタプログラミングと呼ばれる問題に直面します。幸いなことに、90年代からエレガントで効率的なソリューションが開発されており、特にエステレル言語は私たちの問題に完全に適合した構文とセマンティクスを提案しています。 この言語はウェブ技術に適合しており、私たちの音楽シナリオに適合したグラフィカルなプログラミングツールを提案することで、作曲家の作業を簡素化しています。楽曲の制作を例に説明します。まず最初のステップは、デジタルオーディオワークステーションを使ってパターンを作成することです。ここでは、パターンやクリップのデザインに適したツールであるビットウィグスタジオを使用します。パターンが作成されると、そのパターンはスキーニ用の設定ファイルに記述され、持続時間が与えられたり、パターンのセットと関連付けられたりします。パターンセットが重要な役割を果たすのは、それぞれのパターンを個別に操作するのではなく、パターンの集合体を単純に操作できるようにするためです。グラフィカルなプログラミングツールを使って、曲の途中で発生する可能性のあるパターンや様々なイベントのセットを管理することができます。このグラフィック言語の命令の中には、例えば、セットグループという命令があります。これは、一つまたは複数のパターンのセットを、そのセットのパターンを選択して再生するランダムプロセスに対して表示することができます。逆に、unset grups という命令があります。これは、一つまたは複数のパターンのセットをランダムプロセスに対して不可視にすることで、逆のことを行います。イベント管理には、例えば、wait for 命令があり、特定のパターンの再生、特定のセット内のパターンの再生、継続時間のフロー、または複数のイベントの組み合わせなど、特定のイベントが発生するまでフローを停止します。私たちのプログラミング技術の強みの一つは、アクションを連続して記述できるだけでなく、同時に記述できることです。複数のイベントを待ちながら、同時に複数のパターンを実行することが可能です。このような機能はパラレルプログラミングと呼ばれ、ネイティブで提供されている言語はほとんどありません。スキーには、パターンのセットの制御から、テンポの変更、移調、音楽モードの変更など、デジタルオーディオワークステーションへの特定のMIDIコマンドの送信まで、シナリオのデザインを容易にする命令のセットを提供します。シナリオが定義されると、コンポーザーは、シナリオに必要なイベントを生成するランダムエンジンを起動して、その結果を聞くことができます。作曲家は、その結果を記録したり、ランダムなプロセスを実行して連続的に音楽を生成したり、自分の音楽をビデオゲームにインターフェースして、音楽をゲームに合わせることができます。作曲家のイマジネーション次第で様々な使い方ができるのです。
OK! OK, so I will stop the video for a while. It's not necessary now. The only thing that I don't see anyone, I'll check. Do I have a mean to see you? OK, so I will launch the I will switch to English because I have not enough practice in Japanese to make a presentation of my slides, so I will do it in English. I hope my French accent will be not too disturbing for you. Did you hear me well? It's okay?
Yeah.
No. Okay, because at the moment, as I share my screen, I don't see anyone. So I don't know if there is a mod in Zoom to see the people, but I suppose it's not possible when we do a presentation. Okay, it's not a problem. So I will start. Don't hesitate to ask me if the sound is not good or if you don't understand something. I will launch the presentation. I think it's not very long, but okay. I have something as 20 minutes now from now, Ando-san.
Yeah. Okay. Please.
Okay. Okay, so the video was quite short, but I think it was a good way to have a global view of the project. So the project is called Skinny. At the beginning, it was not completely designed for generative music. It was more designed for interactive music. You know, interactive in the sense interaction with the audience. It means how to make people interfere or act on a specific piece of music. So. I will just repeat maybe some basic concepts you just have seen. the first one, the first concept of this project, of the way of creating music using the Skinny system. So the first basic principle is quite simple. It's what I'm call a pattern. A pattern is the basic element, musical element. So it could be, for example, some sounds. Okay, a musical sentence, it could be a sound from, you see, it was, in this case, it was violins. It could be a sound from, what's going on here? Ah, yes, I think I just, I have just to press a key. It could be, yes, different type of sounds, very short, it could be some second, could be percussion. It could be, why not electronic music, techno, or even jazz. So it could be represented, as you see on the screen, using MIDI commands. It could be a score, it could be a sound, okay. So when you have this this basic pattern, you will organize them in groups, let's say, in groups, according to what you want to do. It's completely up to the composer to decide how he will organize the group of patterns. The only thing to keep in mind when you organize the sound is that a specific instrument, and you think more or less like in an orchestra, a specific instrument can play at one time just one pattern. Okay, so you will see in the following slides that it has some impact of the way of organizing the music, because if the system decide to select or to activate different patterns, you have to wait that the first one is played before playing the second one on specific instrument. Okay, this is a specificity of the system, which is interesting in some way. Well, so you have the pattern, you have the group of pattern. Next, the system will use that in order to produce the music. So it's quite simple in the basic concept, you know. So the idea in this case is that a random process will select the pattern. So you will give access to this organization you decided in terms of group of pattern to a specific process which will select inside this pattern according to a random processes. At the beginning, the project was also designed to give access to this pattern to an audience. And this is conceptually, it's very close to have an audience or to have a random process. So according to that, the idea is that the music will evolve according to some events. It could be events from games. It could be even events coming from sensors. It could be events coming, as I just said before, coming from an audience. And these events will interfere with this with the way the pattern will be act, and this is the way basic way to produce music. Alors, as I just said before, the selected patterns are cued by instruments, okay, and the instrument play the content of the cue. Alors, this is the basic idea. Alors, the basic architecture of the system is the following. So you have I will detail more precisely in the following slide how it works, but just to present you a global view. You have, let's say, three or four layers in the system. So we have the central part of the system, which is the Skinny system by itself. It's based on JavaScript technology, so web technologies. And it will use several basic elements. The first one, the most important one, probably in our case, is the orchestration. Of the orchestration is the thing we will discuss just before the slides. It's designed a specific language, in a specific language developed by INRIA here in Irnis, in Sofia Antipolis. So this orchestration will manipulate the pattern we just have seen, and events coming from outside of the platform. So it could be a clock, it could be sensors, it could be video game, it could be an audience also. So the orchestration, we decide according to a specific scenario design invented by the composer, which makes some pattern available to the random engine. So So this is this arrow. The random engine will select a pattern in this available pattern and put it in the queue here. And it can also send some events to orchestration in order to take in, to decide to do something else after that. And once you have the queue here filled by the random engine, they are played regularly by digital audio workstation. So the sound is not produced by the system itself. The sound is produced by a specific digital audio workstation. In my case, I use, of course, a system like Ableton Live, but I use also Bitwig Studio, which is a famous one also. And in order to understand what's happening, you can have a specific display either on a smartphone or either on a computer as you want. So the basic idea of this system in terms of musical consumption is this part, the orchestration. The orchestration is the way to decide what will be available, what could be used in order to produce the music. And in terms of computer science, we are speaking of automaton. It's a kind of automaton, which is quite complex to design in terms of technology, but very easy to imagine or to describe using natural language. So I have very simple use case here in order to show you how it concretely works. So you have here the event on this part. Here I put some patterns, okay, the pattern designed by the composer. And here you have the scenario. Here you have what I call the FIFO. So this is the cue. It could be the instrument if you want. Each one is a different instrument here. And here you have the pattern player, which is the digital audio workstation and the display system. So the first thing which will happen, okay, we have, for example, a clock event from outside. So this clock event, okay, act on the scenario. And in this case, the scenario decide to put directly, it could do without any, in this case, any random engine, but it can decide to put specific pattern in the queue, okay? Once you have the pattern in the queue, clack, they will be played by sequentially by the audio workstation. So if you have another event, for example, coming from a game, something, crossing something or shooting something. So the scenario is activated. He decide also in this case to put a pattern in a queue and another pattern in another queue, another instrument. In this case, the two patterns, as they are on different instruments, different queue, they are played together in the same time because there is no sequence between them. Okay. And what could happen? You see that the arrow light a little bit. The queue can send information to the scenario to tell to the scenario, yes, I just played two patterns, and the scenario could be activated in this case. It decided, for example, it's just an example, to put a new pattern in a new queue. Okay. This was a simple use case without any random process. We will see now exactly the same thing, but with a specific random process. So we have exactly the same idea. For example, we have a clock. The clock activate the scenario. The scenario put some available pattern somewhere, which can be accessed by the random engine. The random engine selects some patterns. For example, it selects only two, why not? And these two patterns are sequentially played by the digital audio workstation. So we have, for example, another event. The scenario is once again activated. Two other patterns are put in the available pattern. So they are seen by the random engine. The random engine selects, like, another pattern. In this case, well, just it's one. And, okay, the second pattern two, for example. And they are, in this case, as previously, put in the same time into the DAW in order to be played. Okay. Like, and okay, in this case, well, just for to finish, you just have a signal coming and cleaning the waiting queue. So the basic idea now, which is complex and difficult, is to imagine how to write the music. The idea from the composer point of view is to imagine how you will order the entries of the different group of patterns, how you want to manage it. So here's the first example of first score I I created some years ago. It's just a way to describe, to tell to the to the system that in this case, I just want to have, for example, here you have the different group of patterns. These are not one pattern in this case. In this, for example, you have here some violin. In the violin, you could have maybe 10 or 20 patterns, which are made available, accessible to the random engine. So during a certain time, in this case, it was described in terms of time. And you have here some smaller rules which describe events, could be events. For example, this event in this case are related to other group of patterns. So for example, here you will be able to access this group of patterns during some time if some people or the random engine give access before that to another one. For example, if you have the pizzicato which are activated, so you can after that access to the violin. So you, this is a way of presenting. I will not go too far. This is another way of describing a scenario, a little bit more computer representation. It was not done by hand completely. So the idea here, you still have the different group of patterns. Here you have the duration of the availability of this group of pattern, which is represented by a line. Here you have another way of representing that, of telling to the system that you will give access to five, you will give access, sorry, for a group of pattern, which is a shallow scale, this is the name of this group, but you will wait in this case for five patterns from this group being activated before giving access to this group of patterns. So you have a sequence of possibility. In this case, you have to wait five, you have to wait to have listened, to have heard to five of these patterns before giving access to the violin, to the viola, to the contrabass, in this case, to the basso. Okay, basically, it's not very difficult to imagine that. You see here that you have a blue rectangle. In this case, it's more or less like this. The difference is that it's a kind of a tank, a reservoir. Maybe you have heard that from people like Penderecki. It means in this case you have the same idea of group of pattern, but you will extract each pattern when it was played. It means you can play it, in this case, a pattern just once. Once it has been played, it disappears from the available pattern. So it's a way to avoid, for example, to have too many repetition of the same pattern. So I think I have sound example here. Yes. So sound example of this small scenario. So you have the flute here. Okay. If we had the time, you could go more deeply into the content of this piece. But it was exactly what's happening. It was exactly described by this part. So okay, we not go on this because it's too long, because the time is going on. So it's just a way to represent, let's say, the score of the music. So I will okay. So I will not detail this. It's the idea that according to the way of describing the music I just presented you, you can combine different scenarios as you want. You can superpose. For example, in this case, I think in the music we will listen, we will have this scenario and this one play together. So it's a way of combining, going towards quite complex organization of scenario, because you can combine, describe scenario and then combine scenario. Okay, here we go. Okay, this is just to tell you that you can get from the system a standard score representation at the end. Okay. So this is the score generated. What you're already seeing, exactly, voilà. Okay. Alors, the most difficult part of the game let's say, is how to for a composer to write the music, to represent the music. So we have two basic way of doing that. The first one, you saw it on the short movie, is to use a graphical tool to describe the scenario. It means the way you want the pattern, the group of pattern to be manipulated. So the simple way, I am using, probably you heard about that, Blockly from the Google, which is a tool designed to create specific specific languages at the beginning for teaching computer science to children, for example. So it's quite easy to manipulate. And the idea is to use high level commands, instruction, in order to describe the music, how the music will behave. I don't see, maybe in this, for example, in this screen, you see you have a small orchestration and you can, for example, display a message, a message on the screen in order to tell to the people that something will happen. You can wait from signal, or signal is something generated by an event. So an event could be, for example, the time, and here you have the notion of tick, which is a timing event. You can have an event coming from the fact that a specific pattern is played, and you can wait for example, you have here, waiting for a pattern play from this group. This group is a NAP Alto group, for example. You can, you can give order to the system, for example, just run a specific tank, or put a pattern in queue, play a specific pattern, for example. So this is quite simple to use, and it's very close to the graphical representation I just showed you before. So I think it's very convenient for people which are not computer scientists. So there is, of course, another way of doing that. It's to use a specific language, which is called hip-hop.js, which is developed here in at INRIA in Sofia Antipolis. So exactly the same philosophy, but you have to use a specific text editor, or to use computer science environment, which is sometimes less easy than just using graphical interface. So I will not detail this one because I think it's more for computer scientists. I'm not sure all the people online are computer scientists. So we go very quickly on that. Okay, so the idea, as you understand, it's possible using this kind of language to have very complex orchestration. It means you have a combination of complex events and generate, of course, quite complex scores or complex music. So I think I have two examples here. I just maybe will play this example, you know, just for you to listen to what you can do. Of course, it's not limited to this example. You can do the music you want. For example, you can have a jazz rock style music here, which works quite well. Okay, I will stop because it may be a bit too long. I see that time is passing. So for example, in this case, it's this piece of music, which is called Grand Loup. It was only, it was 80 patterns in this case, divided in six groups. And I give an idea of the length of the code generated by the system, but it's not so meaningful for you. It's not very long, it's 200, almost 300 lines. It's quite short. In this case, you have only two signals. It means you have only signals. Maybe it's not easy to explain very quickly, but it is the basic element which are used by hip-hop.js in order to to manipulate the data. It's not based on variables, it's based on signals. So I will go to the next slide. Alors, the idea after that, once you have the system which generate music more or less using or not a random process, you may want to check if your music is really following what you decided. It's very in line with the basic scenario, the basic orchestration you design. So if you use, you have several ways to check that. If you use, for example, Ableton Live, you can record what's happening. And if you record what's happening, you can have, maybe using color, a way to check that what you did is in line with the basic element, the basic orchestration you decided. And for example, in this case, it was okay. I think this is more or less this one, probably. So I could check that the pattern I fear are exactly the one which are planned to be in this area. And here, okay, you can check using that the different area and see that it evolves according to what you decide. What you can also do if you have time is to generate a score and tell that the score you get at the end is close to what you design here. Okay. So, okay, the technical architecture, we just saw it, it's not necessary to have a look. So I think I will finish with that. I was a little bit long because I think it was only 30 minutes. So sorry for that. Let's see how to stop the... Merde, j'ai perdu. Okay, sorry, I lose the Zoom for a while. So if you have any question, if we have time, I am of course at your disposal to share some point to be more clear, because I think it was a bit short.
Okay, thanks so much for your presentation. 何か会場から質問はありますか?
はい、今堀さんお願いします。こんにちは、今堀さん。こんにちは。Bonjour。Bonjour。
Qu'est-ce que ça veut dire le mot orchestre simple pour vous? C'est-à-dire que normalement, on pense il y a un arrangement. Peut-être une pièce pour le piano et on fait pour un grand orchestre. Normalement, oui. On dit orchestration pour comme ça. Mais dans votre présentation, orchestration signifie une autre chose.
Exactement. You're right. In fact, I use the word orchestration because it was a little bit not a joke, but it's a mix of the way we use orchestration in computer science, you know, and the way we are using orchestration in music. It's an in between, because you know, orchestration in computer science is a way of organizing different processes in order to have the process working together in a good way, let's say. And this is what, in this case, we speak also of automaton, for example. Yeah. And the language I am using, hip hop, is based on STL, which is completely dedicated to this kind of context. It means to have computer orchestration, let's say. But in some way, as we are manipulating instruments, musical patterns you attribute to instruments, it's not so far from the orchestration of in the musical sense, you know. And but you're right. It's not exactly the same meaning that the orchestration you are using in music. But it's not so far in some way, because when we describe a score, telling, for example, I want to have the violin in this part, I want to have the cello in this part, I want to have the piano in this part. Okay. It's more or less what we call orchestration in music. Even if it's not exactly
same. Sorry, somebody said to ask. To translate my question in English. So my question was the word, what the word orchestration means. Normally, it was how to say the arrangement from piano piece orchestra.
No, you're right.
Orchestra.
You're right. Maybe. Now, sometimes you see in the Japanese video I just presented you before, I don't use orchestration. I use scenario. The word scenario. Maybe scenario is better. Maybe. You're right.
Yeah. Thank you very much.
Thanks so much.
どうもありがとうございます。
時間が来ましたので、最初のプレゼンテーションはこれで終わります。Time is over, so thanks for your presentation. It is finished.
ありがとうございます。どうもありがとうございました。